I don't really remember when they started. I had headaches periodically all the time. And then one day I just was like, I don't remember not having a headache. So I've had headaches every hour of every day for at least 8 or 9 years, and migraines 2 or 3 times a week on top of that. First, I was just on medicine after medicine after medicine, and nothing helped. I've been on anti-seizure medicine, I've been on antidepressants, I've been on everything you can think of. Most of the neurologists I went to didn't know what to think of me. They saw like all the stuff I had been on, and they were like, well, anything we can think of giving you is close to the same thing that you've already been on. And some doctors even told me that they didn't think I had anything, and they thought I was just making everything up. Anytime I got a really bad headache, I would lay in bed for forever, but my personality just wouldn't let me. No matter how bad I felt, I had to just get on with my life. So I would go to school with a migraine, even if I couldn't like open my eyes or even pay attention. I would just show up. I would try to live my life as best as I could in the situation that I had, but it was just difficult for me to do that. A lot of times, physical pain actually helped my head, so I enjoyed doing sports. But a lot of times, right after I finish a game or something, I couldn't go out with the team because I was hurting so bad. I just had to go home and fall asleep, get out of any place that had lights or loud noises or anything. For 8, 9 years, I had a steady 6 every hour of every day, and 2 or 3 times a week, it would spike up to an 8 or a 9 and stay there for sometimes a couple days, sometimes just a couple hours, but most of the time I would just fall asleep, and most of the time it would be better the next morning, but a lot of times I would have to wait a couple days for it to ever come back down, but it would never go below a 5, and most of the time it was at a 6. And after I had the procedure, right after I found the frequency that worked best for me, it dropped straight down to a 2, and it's been around a 2 ever since. At first, I was like, I don't know if I want something implanted in my head and down my back, because I've dealt with this headache for years, and I wasn't gonna let it ruin my life. It took away a lot, but I didn't want something invasive in my body making it so I couldn't go do sports, because I was still playing sports. The stimulator is not hard to use at all. I have to charge it like once every other week, and it takes like 5, 10 minutes to charge, and it's just a belt I put around it, and a sensor just goes over where the battery is on my hip, and it charges it while I'm watching TV or driving or something. And then I can turn it on and off with a magnet, just swipe it over the battery, and it turns it off or on if I ever need to do that. A lot of times I sleep with it off, but mostly besides that, I usually have it on all the time. And then if I ever want to change the frequency, which I don't do as much now that I've had it for a while, it's just a little remote that I can hold over it, and it's really easy to control. After the final procedure, I was back coaching gymnastics. I was back doing flips off walls, jumping on the trampoline, doing flips on that, playing slam ball out in my backyard, which is, we lower the basketball goal to 8.5 feet, and it's really physical. There's no fouls called, and it's a really rough game, so I've been able to do everything since. I hadn't had not a headache in 9 years. I didn't even remember what it felt like, and it felt terrific. The stimulator just feels like someone's massaging my head, and my head hasn't felt this great since I can remember. Dr. Reed has done a miracle.